Welcome to Pray With Me, a daily prayer time with Father Alphonse. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, and she conceived by the Holy Spirit. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Behold the handmaid of the Lord, be it done unto me according to thy word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ your Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection through the same Christ our Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I would like to pray for a strong determination to follow the command of Jesus to love one another as he has loved us. Today is Holy Thursday, April 1st, Psalm 83. God, do not be silent. God, do not be deaf or remain unmoved. See how your enemies rage. Your foes proudly raise their heads. They conspire against your people, plot against those you protect. They say, come, let us wipe them out as a nation. Let Israel's name be remembered no more. They scheme with one mind. They have entered into a covenant against you. The tents of Edom and the Ishmaelites of Moab and the Hagrites, Gebel, Ammon, and Amalek, Philistia, and the inhabitants of Tyre, Assyria too, in league with them, backs the descendants of Lot. Deal with them as with Midian, as with Sisera and Jabin at the Wadi Kishon, those destroyed at Endor, those who became dung for the ground. Make their nobles like Oreb and Zeb, all their princes like Zeba and Zalmunna, who made a plan together. Let us take for ourselves the pastures of God. My God, make them like tumbleweed, into chaff flying before the wind, as a fire raging through a forest, a flame setting mountains ablaze. Pursue them with your tempest, terrifying them with your storm wind. Cover their faces with shame till they seek your name, Lord. Let them be ashamed and terrified forever. Let them perish in disgrace. Let them know that your name is Lord. You alone are the Most High over all the earth. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Psalm 83 has lots of names, right? And it might be misleading for you, but a brief explanation would be helpful. This is a community's lament complaining to God of the nations' attempts to wipe out the name of Israel. The psalmist sees all Israel's enemies throughout its history united in a conspiracy. May God destroy the current crop of enemies as the enemies of old were destroyed. And may they be pursued until they acknowledge the name of Israel's God. In seeking the face of God refers the worshiper having recourse to the temple or the sanctuary, where in non-Jewish context, a statue embodies the physical presence of the deity. But in Israel, an iconic tradition no visible image or statue can represent God. This understanding conveyed here concretely by use of the term your name rather than more typical your face. As I said today, we are celebrating the Maundy Thursday or Holy Thursday. Maundy is order, or command. The command that Jesus gives us today is to love one another as Jesus has loved us. And how did he love us? He stooped down to the feet of the disciples, to the servants, to wash their feet. And that much he loved. And also he was lifted up on the cross and he was crucified and he gave up his life in the process of redeeming those who have been lost to sin and to this world. That is the love of Jesus Christ. And he says, love one another as I have loved you, which means we should put ourselves low and give precedence to others. And love towards others is already meaningful. The meaning of loving others is that you trust them, you respect them, you do not do anything to do harm to them. In other words, you are in harmony and you are ready to put yourself down and lift them up. Let us pray. O Lord God, may this Holy Thursday and the coming days of Triduum, the Friday and Holy Saturday, Good Friday and Holy Saturday, we may be able to follow, observe these days as special in the whole of the liturgical year. Thus we may prepare ourselves for the coming feast of Pasqua, the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. Give us the fruits of his redemption as we meditate upon Jesus being handed over to the enemies, suffering and taking up his cross, walking towards the Calvary and dying there and being buried. In the precious name of Jesus Christ, who your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. May Almighty God bless you, Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace. Thank you for joining me in this prayer. If you are blessed by this time of prayer, please click on the like, share, or subscribe button and share with others. May God bless you.